Hey guys, I've finally taken your advice and successfully broke the fabric of time and space. Anyway, I've traveled from a point in time where it's that time of year again. So here is my top 10 films of 1996. At number 10 is Maximum Risk. This movie will be sure to have you saying, "Van Damme, son!" That is some risky behavior. In fact, the behavior represented in this film is at the maximum level of risk. There is no level of riskiness that could surpass what is shown in this film. Now, although the film did not explicitly show it, it is heavily implied that the main character never wore a condom throughout the course of the entire movie. Wow, now that's what I call method acting. Let's take a look.
Jean-Claude Van Damme and Natasha Henstridge of Species. Maximum Risk. Welcome to the other side of safe.
At number 9 is Feeling Minnesota. Keanu Reeves delivers his best performance since the crowd-pleasing epic Sneeze featured in The Lake House. Here is a clip for those of you who have not experienced its majesty. Let's take a look. Now, very much like The Lake House, this film has Keanu Reeves and his acting in the film. Now, some of you might say that such a blatant ripoff in casting makes this film seem like an overall ripoff of The Lake House, but it's not. It's good. I like it. It's good. I think it's good. Let's take a look.
I can see us in Vegas, lying by a pool with water in it.
How does something like this happen to me?
And she was my wife!
She didn't want to be with you.
So why couldn't she love me anyway?
At number 8 is The Crow 2, City of Angels. It's just like The Crow 1, except nobody dies. Let's take a look.
The Crow, City of Angels.
At number 7 is Lawnmower Man 2, Beyond Cyberspace. This rare jewel of a film had me sucked into its world, its cyber world. It was only 10 minutes into the film before I shouted out in the theater, "Why? What have I done to deserve this?" The rest is history, cyber history. Let's take a look.
Mr. Hope.
He was a lawnmower man
till my next door neighbor did some experiments with him and turned him into a genius.
I am God here.
Welcome to my world, Peter.
I found the secret to immortality in the chiral chip.
The future, sir,
is now.
Get him out of there.
He's getting out of control.
I've never seen Job like that before.
You've got to stop Job before it's too late.
And in 3 days, I'll be in every system in the world.
At number 6 is The Nutty Professor. Eddie Redmayne delivers a powerful yet poignant performance as he plays the rogue agent, Eddie Murphy, a tall and noble man who is faced with the extreme challenge of learning how to live and love while partying all the time. This magnificent film challenges us as audience members and reminds us of a time when obesity was a laughing matter and not a national health crisis. Let's take a look.
I don't know why everybody trying to lose weight in the first place.
You're talking about that's healthy. I know what healthy is.
And his love life.
I'm a big fan.
Thank you very much. I'm fatter.
Flattered.
Was disastrous. But now, thanks to the miracle of science, he's about to make a change for the thinner.
At number 5 is Bogus. Whoopi Goldberg and Casey Joel Affleck star in this nail-biting thriller wherein a special little boy starts to see dead people that no one else can. Now, unlike The Sixth Sense, where the ghosts seem relatively playful and harmless, the ghost in this film is French. Crazy, right? Now watch as he tricks this unsuspecting family into trusting him only to later find out that the Christmas spirit isn't as wholesomely spiritual as they once thought. Let's take a look.
What's important?
You gotta get strong. Gotta learn to grow up.
I haven't had a conversation with a child since I was a child.
She needs a friend. You should try.
I don't want to try.
What's not?
Fish cakes.
We like nachos.
We like nachos.
Well, we don't have no nachos. We have fish cakes.
If I live here, I'll die.
I could lose my job.
Why are you scared?
Why are you pushing him away? Would you like to see me?
What do you need?
Where were you?
When I was little.
I was there.
Oh, yeah?
What's real?
This is nuts.
No, it's not nuts. It's imagination.
And what's bogus?
Bogus means fake.
Bogus is not fake.
Don't you shout at me, young man.
From award-winning director Norman Jewison, Whoopi Goldberg.
She has a funny hair, huh?
Gerard Depardieu and Haley Joel Osment.
You're my best friend. My only friend. You're my Mona Me.
At number four is Mulholland Falls from the director of Die Another Day and XXX2, The Next Level, comes this seat-biting thriller that will have you hanging onto the edge of your nails. Watch as Naomi Watts plays a woman suffering from amnesia who must find out who killed her wife by getting crazy tattoos and writing on the backs of Polaroid photographers. Let's take a look.
If you break the law, you'll have to answer to a special squad of detectives.
This is Mulholland Falls, Jack.
You guys can't do this. This is America.
This isn't America, Jack. This is L.A.
With their own brand of justice.
Four men, no politics, no favors. We answer to nobody.
At number three is Big Bully. This crazy fever dream of epic proportions shows us just how much each and every one of us wants to stare deeply into Tom Arnold's eyes. Rick Moranis, however, has not yet proven us to be the number four handsome boy, and I'm deeply fearful that one day deep into the distant future, he never will. As for the movie, it's pretty fab. To quote the great Roger Ebert, Big Bully is pretty much almost as hilarious and riveting as his 2011 sequel, Cyber Bully. Great job! Let's take a look.
Yes! In your face!
It's Rick Moranis and Tom Arnold in a comedy that doesn't pull its punchlines.
I can explain! What? More peas?
So get ready to laugh.
What are you gonna do, style my hair?
Ah! Till it hurts. Big Bully.
At number two is Unforgettable. Although I do not remember exactly what this film was about, I do know that it was pretty dank. So how could I possibly say no to including it on this list? Am I right, ladies? Let's take a look.
And one woman who may hold the solution.
To date, I've made successful transfers of neuroelectrical impulses.
An experimental drug that can retrieve his wife's memories and prove his innocence.
So you've really transferred memory?
Yeah, and lab rats.
I'd be willing to try it.
That would be completely irresponsible.
Now, he's going to have to recall someone else's past.
It works. It was like a raw experience. It was like I was actually there.
You have no idea what you've done to yourself.
Feel.
And my number one film of the year is a very Brady sequel. I've never watched the original film, and I've never seen an episode of The Brady Bunch, but this film had me laughing to my grave. The little grave boy had to dig me up because I was laughing so loud. He was fired the next day. This film is undoubtedly the absolute pinnacle of filmmaking achievement. This was even more hilarious than Hacksaw Ridge. A Very Brady sequel is my favorite movie of all time, and I guarantee you will enjoy its mystical prowess. Let's take a look.
A story about family.
I need some advice.
Put yourself up for adoption.
About romance.
I'll make up an imaginary boyfriend. Nice try, Jan.
Ha, 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 ha. baby boy. Yes, 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 no, yes, 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 yes.
Oh, hello, and welcome to YourMovieSucks.org. I'm Eric, your host, and today we're going to take a look at some wonderful reviews of movies and learn how to leave proper and respectful etiquette in the comment sections. Let's just pick a video at random on this channel that you're watching this on. See what this channel's all about, huh?
Want to know what I think of M. Night?
Yeah, what the fuck? Now, much like my boy Big Man Tyrone right here, Adam's paying me $5 to do this video, so that's awesome. He wrote the whole thing for me, too, so keep that in mind. And if I actually go off script at any point, I'm going to receive an electrical shock from this device, which is called the Neuro EEG Biofeedback Simulator. No, shit, stimulator. Ah! Ah! Stop! Ah!
Stop is not in the script, man. I'm sorry, just stick to the script and I won't have to hurt you.
But hey, it's worth the $5. And then Eric gets shocked. Wait, what?
Don't say the part that's the action part. That's not your lines. Good boy.
Hey, my name is Eric, and I suck police officers' penises. I'm a crippled baby pooping in my diaper. Don't kiss me. I don't ever want to be kissed. This is Eric saying this as myself, and I fucked a turtle when I was 8. Since then, I've fucked more turtles than there are turtles on the planet. Let's check out a movie review.
Okay, I've seen over 70 films from 2009. I've seen a lot of bad movies in my life, but this is the first time I've ever used the word sloppy to describe someone's directing.
God, he sounds young.
Directed by Michael Bay.
Worth it. And skip.
Yes, I know, I'm ripping off Red Letter Media. I don't care.
Great stuff. Time to leave my comment. Now pay close attention to how I deliver my critique with logical reasoning and solid examples. Here we go. Fuck you, man. Precious was a gem of a movie. I loved Queen Latifah as the mom. She was fucking awesome. I used to have a band in high school called Team Laqueefa. It was great. We only did Joy Division covers. Anyway, fuck you, Adam, you goddamn $5 April Fool spending motherfucker. You hate this movie because you can't root for the underdog unless, of course, they're dressed in an actual dog costume. In conclusion, this dude hates good movies. Precious was a breath of fresh air. And Babadook was the best horror movie of the decade. And post! Alright, hey, that's a pretty good comment. Why didn't I get zapped for that? Oh. Alright. Up, you know what? That was actually in the script. Well, everything checks out here. Now, before we go, Adam left me a little note to read to you. It's called The Genius of Schenectady, New York, Part 5. Whatever that is. Hey guys, Adam here. Sorry I didn't have enough time to put this on tape, but here's the final part of my Schenectady, New York analysis. Philip Seymour Hoffman did a good job acting. The makeup effects were pretty good, too. In conclusion, it was a good movie, and there are lots of references to other things in it. Signed, Tyrone. Wait a second, Tyrone, did you write this note?
I do not know of this Tyrone you speak of. My name is Adam, and I'm a movie reviewer for the popular YouTube channel, YourMovieNotGood.com. I'm afraid you are mistaken.
No. Adam is Adam. You are Tyrone.
Now look here, you crazy hippie. I've already told you twice that my name is Adam. Everyone watching this video already knows that I'm Adam. I've been reviewing all of the best movies on this channel for the past 50 years. How can you possibly expect to prove me wrong when we have millions of people watching who already know the truth?
I'll show you. I'll prove it to you. Here.
The Lion King, my favorite animated movie of all time. Yes, I'm a little biased when it comes to this movie, but although it's not perfect, I still think that it's the best animated kids movie ever made.
Oh, yeah? Well, how about this? Rock clip! The Lion King, my favorite animated movie of all time. Yes, I'm a little biased when it comes to this movie. But although it's not perfect, I still think that it's the best animated kids movie ever made. Check and mate, you crazy hippie.
Holy shit. Wait a second. Do you think?
So the legends are true. This must be.
The Mandela effect?
Oh my! Oh my sweet baby boy! Now this is a good movie review right here. Mufasa!
I'm just a little person, one person in a sea.
Alright, so my final thoughts on your moviesucks.org is, it needs more politics. You gotta put more politics in this channel, man. It's just not funny enough. Politics are funny. That's what people want. You got to add politics. Good night.